welcome to stay.
Usted inglés?
A little.
A little. Are you here to ride?
No, I look for work.
For work?
Sí.
What is your name?
¿Cómo?
¿Cómo te llama?
Pilar Moreno.
Pilar. Well, Pilar, I own the joint.
You are manager.
That too, yeah. How well do you ride? You can show me? Antonio, bring Maggie over. Antonio, tell Pilar that I would like to see her ride.
Dice que quiere ver cómo monta.
¿Dónde? You were up early. I was up at 7 and you were gone by then.
Couldn't sleep. Well, I'll take the bike now.
You should leave a note, boy. We never know where you are.
It's only got a couple of hours.
I saw you in the old town. Talking to Marcus Tandy.
What?
Gave you some money. What for?
I delivered a letter for him yesterday.
I told you to stay away from him.
I was doing him a favour, that's all.
You can't do favours for people like that. He'll just take advantage of you.
I'm not stupid, Jim.
Can we take a vote on that one?
Nessa. Look, he may look glamorous, splashing his money about, but he's a crook. He'll get you into trouble. Blair.
Okay.
Marcus Tandy.
Who are you?
Philip Wentworth, Mr. Tandy, BBC Television. We'd like to ask you a few questions about your business activities on the Costa El Dorado.
It's none of your business.
Mr. Tandy, isn't it true that the money used to support your present lifestyle came from a series of share and property frauds that you operated between 85 and 87?
You've been reading too many fairy stories, my friend.
Are you aware that one of your investors, a Mr. Napata Singh, committed suicide a few months ago?
Take your foot out of my door.
What can you tell us about the mortgage you arranged for Mr. Singh? Mr. Tandy!
Your wages.
Gracias.
Pilar, seeing as how you're saving for the future, I thought perhaps I could take you out tonight. I thought maybe we could have some champagne on my boat. Have you ever had champagne? You'll like it. You'll like it. It's like lemonade, only has a little kick. So I thought if you came down to the marina at about 9, I can arrange for some food.
I see other people tonight.
Which other people?
Friends. I can't come through your boat. Thank you.
So English. So splendidly, splendidly English.
God who made thee mighty,
you!
You know, you won't always be able to say no to me. Because, I always get what I want in the end.
It can't go on like this, Jim.
Oh, I only had a few drinks, that's all.
Oh, your few drinks I can cope with. I can even take the odd collapse into the swimming pool, but... this is getting out of hand. You know it, I know it. I mean, we've been all through this before. We don't want a repeat performance, do we?
I'm sorry.
I don't want you being sorry either. I just want to understand why.
Perdón, do you know where is Pilar Moreno?
Who?
Isn't she that Spanish girl who works at the riding stables?
Sorry I'm not much company this evening. But if I don't get these lesson plans finished, I'll be back at school before I know it.
Have you and Dad had a row, Mum?
We don't have arguments. We had a difference of opinion.
Look, Mum, I'm just going to pop out for a bit.
What? No. All right, then, but...
Don't be long and don't go far. Yes, I know.
Sometimes I think you know far too much for your own good, young lady.
Knowledge is power, Mum. That's what I think.
Te queremos. Estábamos preocupados.
Te escribí que estaba bien.
You know, your brother was very worried about you.
I'm not going back. They made me work like a donkey.
Pilar, you know, you should really say hello to your brother properly, you know?
He'll take me home.
He won't. I promise. He just wants to know that you're all right.
You're a sad act. A very sad act.
Get up, Dad, and hang on to the back.
Hey, Freddie. Have you thought any more about my offer?
Which offer's that?
Oh, you know, cooking, cleaning, shopping, washing, anything you like.
The gesture is appreciated, but as I told you yesterday, I'm quite capable of looking after myself. Now, if you don't mind, I'm already late for lunch, and I hate to keep anyone waiting.
Is it a man?
I beg your pardon?
Is that who you're meeting for lunch? Another man? Because you're not normal, are you?
Look, Blair, what's your game? If you've got something to say, say it.
I don't mind if you're queer, but other people might.
Is that it?
I won't tell anyone, though. They can work it out for themselves.
Fortunately, Blair, most people are much brighter than you. Everybody knows about my personal life. I should find something else to gossip about.
Won't cost you much to keep me quiet.
Marcus Tandy, eat your heart out. I do declare I'm being blackmailed.
A few thousand pesetas and I'll keep my mouth shut.
You're selling yourself a bit short there, aren't you? A secret this big should be worth millions.
I'm not greedy.
You are a nasty piece of work. Has anyone ever told you that?
Hey, Freddie. What do you think?
I think you need to cool off.
Mark.
Marcus found out something about me. Something I never told you.
What do you mean Marcus found out something about you? I mean, what, that you don't wipe the bath after you use it, that you cut your toenails in bed? I'm your wife, Drew. What could he possibly find out about you that I don't already know?
Years ago, before I met you, I did 18 months in prison. And that was with time off for good behaviour.
I knew that.
What?
You've come to plead for that pathetic husband of yours, right? Why the sudden interest? Why am I offering him the chance to make a fortune, is that it?
We don't need your interest or your money.
Listen, I'm trying to do your husband a favour. Once he gets used to the idea, he'll see sense. So will you. I mean, come on, Gwen. You're not exactly making a fortune, are you?
How we choose to make a living is our affair. I just want you to know that there are no secrets in my family. Not anymore. I know all about Drew's past. We don't need offers of any kind from you. We don't need advice or your so-called help. And most of all, we can do without your blackmail threats. Do you understand?
God blimey. I wonder who wears the trousers around at your house. All right. That's the line. On that side, we've got Spain, we've got your family, we've got the church. On this side, we've got me, Marcus Tandy. No promises, just more of the same. Now you choose, but you choose now. You either cross the line or you walk away. Either way is fine by me.
Dígame. Speaking. Yeah, yeah, I do. Sorry? Oh, right. Yeah, I see.
Oi! This is Fizz. This is my wife, Fizz.
All right.
Gavin, could I have a word, please?
I wonder what that's all about.
Do you want me to come give you a hand?
Daddy, isn't it?
This morning.
Is that all right?
Actually, I think I'll leave it.
Leave it?
Truth is, I don't like conflicts.
Nothing, cowboys.
What are you on about?
Marcus stuffing Tandy, that's who. See these? All complaints. Cost a fortune. As if I haven't got enough on me plate already. And he's in the clear, that's what gets me.
Hey, take it easy, man. It's not the end of the world, you know.
It's not you they're after, is it? Shouting and raving. It's gonna cost them a fortune.
If it's Tandy's business, why can't he put it right?
Because the company's just filed for bankruptcy, that's why. It's all been a con from start to finish.
All you did was sell them the timeshare, though.
Yeah, but they're all after me, aren't they? All getting at me. I took their money, didn't I? They're all getting me, just like the others.
What others?
You know, them.
It'll be the son. It gets him like that sometimes.
Are you going to tell me why you visited the supermarket?
It's not going to work, Fizz.
What are you on about?
You and that supermarket. It's more like a social club. In short, I think you'd be best out of it. I'll go and hand in your notice tomorrow.
Look, Bunny Charlson, husband or no husband, I don't need your permission or anyone else's permission to let me work in that supermarket. And don't let me ever catch you spying me again. Is that clear?
You wanna...
Messed things up. But did you care about me, Fizz? I need to know. It's important. I need to know even now.
Yes, Bunny, I cared. As much as I can, I really cared.
Then that doesn't have to be the end of it, does it? I love you, Fizz.
It's not what I want, Bunny. It's not what I want. I'm sorry.
Vamos, rápido.
I know this man. He's one of my patients.
Who's there? Who are you? How did you get in here?
I'm Jim. I'm a friend of Fizz. And there's lots of other ways we can help and all. I've been reading up on it, Mum.
So why, Gavin?
What?
Why is it him that's got this...
Schizophrenia. It's more common than you think. But it can be treated.
Back home in England. Not out here.
The body of a young woman was found yesterday under Palace Pier. It had been washed up on the high tide. Two pieces of jewellery, a plain gold wedding ring and a locket.
I could be any young married woman.
I gave her a locket. Oh, my Lord!
Of course. Yes, of course. Take as long as you need. And listen, Bunny. Bunny?
What did you say?
Hang up.
Was it Bunny
and the girl?
It was Fizz. It was Fizz.
Pilar,
what are you doing here? Go and finish your lunch. Go!
Now, what is a pretty young girl like you doing eating all alone?
Marcus has trouble at the risco.
What kind of trouble?
Someone has made lots of damage. Everything is broken. There's writing.
Writing?
But it's okay. Marcus says it's nothing.
Listen, love. This is none of my business. But you are a nice girl. You should have a nice lad. Spanish, English, whatever. But someone that is straight, down to earth, and safe. Now, take my advice. Get out while you can.
Sure about this?
Sure, we're sure. We wanted action. This is where the action is. So I'm told, anyway.
Charlie, they're about 12 years old.
Okay, so they're 12. They need the experience of a really mature woman.
But what does the mature woman get out of this?
You are such a pessimist. You ready?
Okay, I'm ready.
Right then, let us go in there and show them what a real woman's made of.
Yeah, an uplift bra and a pair of false eyelashes. Come on, darling.
Too? What does that mean?
I saw your face. You thought I could be here. You were scared.
Fix me a drink. I don't get scared, Pilar. Ever. But I do get very irritated when people go on and on about the same thing, okay? Now change the record.
I should know what's happening.
You should know all you need to know and nothing else. Now, I'll sort out this problem because that's what I'm good at. You fix the drinks because that's what you're good at, okay?
Oh, excuse me. Ah, hello.
Hi.
You're not in your shop?
No, well, Lena's at the clinic, so...
And I was just coming to see you.
Were you?
Yes. Actually, I want you to look at your sweaters.
Fine, good.
If I come down later, will you be there to show me some?
Yes. I think so.
You in person?
Yes. After 12?
I'll see you then. With my checkbook.
Pilar, look, please. I've had a really lousy day. I really strongly advise you against getting difficult.
I'm leaving.
What?
Goodbye, Marcus. I have left all the clothes you bought me. No doubt you can find somewhere else to wear them.
Go on, and sling your axe if like you. Go on.
And this may be yours, I think. I only want what I came with.
How does it look?
Very nice.
Is there enough room here?
Yes, I think so.
Yes, I'll take it. You see, I need something warm for tonight. Philippe and I are going up into the mountains to hear flamenco. Can you wrap it, please? Not for tourists, of course. The real thing. 40 kilometers inland, right away from all this.
6,200. I envy you. I like flamingo too.
Why don't you come too?
Sorry?
Come with us?
My wife unfortunately has to work this evening.
Husbands and wife aren't Siamese twins, are they?
Of course, no.
So come on your own then. Philippe and I will be very pleased. Really?
Well, thank you very much.
Bonsoir.
Gwinnett.
Where the hell is she?
no joy.
What do you think you're doing? I thought you were a professional, not some stupid amateur who doesn't turn up for a gig.
Here, hold on.
I have had ravers on my phone all day asking where the hell you are.
Yeah, well, there has been a slight problem. I haven't forgotten.
Oh, Trish, what happened?
Well, I know it's normally me that gets plastered, but this time it was my foot. I fell and twisted it. Bad boy, Dieter. I really must stop swinging from the chandeliers, dear.
Well, Trish, what about the gig? You could at least have phoned and told them.
Told them what?
That you're not coming.
Who says I'm not coming?
It's all right. This'll do.
Oh, great. Now we'll show them what a real trooper is.
You might as well be living in Catford, eh, Miss King?
I beg your pardon?
The way standards are declining around here.
Yes, well, they won't be declining when I'm president of the Residents Association, Mr. Tandy. I can assure you of that.
You missed a bit.
Let's give her some earrings, too. Make her look like Gypsy Rose Lee.
She looks more like Nelly the Elephant in drag.
Oh, what about some little glasses, too?
Oh, yeah.
Give her a touch of the Bessie Bonders.
Snowy.
Yeah. I'm not too sure about that beard. It's just a small pencil moustache. Now, that's a real Picasso if I ever saw one. What do you think?
The evidence. I'll now ask my husband, will you please tell us the truth behind that picture?
All right, yes. So we went to the fair in Fuengirola. But it was not to be together, as you might think. It was to escape.
But why? If this is so, why all these lies? And why do you both act so guilty?
We felt guilty, like naughty children. What can I say?
The truth.
It is the truth.
Isabel, is this the truth?
No. I confess to you, Lene, that I have sexual feelings for your husband. And I assume is she the same for him?
Well, what can I say?
The truth is simple and stupid. No matter what we desire, it was just never the right moment. C'est la vie. And after all, if there's no sex, there's no affair.
Not yet.
Not ever. Not now.
¿Qué pasa? No es mi cumpleaños.
Mamá, we're engaged.
Oh, that's wonderful. ¿Qué te han prometido? You're the first to know. Where's the padre? You must telephone your family.
I'm gonna have a surfing lesson.
Oh, go on, go on.
They will be surprised.
Freddy, what's the matter? You look as if you've seen a ghost.
That?
This? I got it from the car boot sale.
Oh, sorry. So stupid. Of course. This gave me quite a turn seeing it. Seeing you standing there like that.
Oh, Freddie.
Just for a split second,
I'm sorry, look, I didn't realise. I'll never wear it again.
No, it's nice. It's nice to see it used again. Really. You wear it as much as you like.
Ingrid and I have something to tell you. Something important.
You have not booked the church, have you?
No, it's nothing like that. It's to do with Christmas.
Christmas? What about Christmas?
We have decided we want to spend Christmas in Stockholm with her family.
You have what? Christmas in Stockholm?
You're joking, aren't you?
Why should we be joking, Roberta?
When was this decided? Why wasn't this mentioned before?
Javier was worried about telling you.
I'm not surprised. What are you thinking about, Javier? You know how much this is going to upset your mother?
Yes?
Natalie. Bristol, 1956. Does that ring a bell? You can make me stand out here.
No.
I've got everything wrong, haven't I? Even my timing.
Oh, no. No, that's just Jerry. Jerry, put a sock in it! Nobody that you know.
I got some good news for you. I've just been offered a job.
That's fantastic.
But I don't think I want it.
Why not? What is it?
Manager of the stables.
Los Barcos.
Where else? It would only be temporary, but it would mean I'd have somewhere to live and somewhere to work. It'll give us some more time.
That's Marco Stanley's stables.
Well, that's the bad news.
Forget it. I don't want you working with some crook.
Excuse me?
She's an international drug smuggler and you're working undercover for the CIA.
And you're a pain in the rear.
Oh, thanks very much.
Well, you will go on.
It's all right. Just thought we were mates, that's all.
We are. Jerry.
Look.
I knew you'd tell me in the end.
Oh, there are times I could cheerfully strangle you.
Look, Freddie, I know you. I can tell there's something bothering you, but I can't help you if you won't tell me what it is.
Well, I don't quite know where to start.
Start with the basics, like who's the girl?
She's my daughter.
This really is very good. I'm impressed.
Is this one done?
Yes.
That's great. Hey, look, you know, if you're going to work for me, Ingrid, you're going to have to cultivate a sense of humour.
OK. And may I have one or two things clear as well?
Of course.
One, I don't like to be touched, fondled or groped by people I work with. Two, I will not be treated as a sex object. And three, I'm sorry, but I'm afraid these little boys' pictures, which maybe you, Marcus, like very much, will have to... go.
Who's this? It's a nice frame. Must be someone special.
Is Ingrid coming back for lunch?
She's just gone for a walk along the beach.
Javier, what is it?
What is what?
She's pregnant, isn't she? Well?
We were going to tell you. We were waiting for the right moment.
Well, are you pleased, Javier?
Yes.
Then so are we. Are we, Rosario?
But I need to explain you something about Ingrid.
What about me?
Ingrid, congratulations.
Javier's just told us the wonderful news.
Clear the air, Freddie. You owe that much to her. You also owe it to yourself.
Yes,
but what if you stay in the closet? You'll never know. Tell her, Freddie.
His name was John.
And he wasn't a relative of Jerry's. He was a friend of mine. You were right about one thing. The eyes do follow you everywhere. They were deep set and grey, and I never loved anyone in my whole life as much as I loved him.
Well, did you tell her?
Yes, I told her.
And? Good?
I don't know. I don't know what she thought. She went off somewhere. Left a note, needed time to think.
She'll be all right. Don't you worry, Freddie.
Yeah. Anyway, what's going on here? Are you choosing outfits for a gig?
No, dear, I'm choosing outfits for life.
This friend of yours, the one that visits on Saturday nights, what's his name?
Paco.
And is it a serious relationship?
I'm not sure I know how to answer that. It's serious enough for us to meet every week and for me to remain faithful.
But not like you and John.
Oh, no. I don't think I ever expected that. You can't replace people.
I'd like to meet him.
What? I don't think that would be a good idea at all.
Why not?
What happens if you finally decide that all this has been a big mistake? And you've got every right to. Well, then, what do I do? What have I got left?
Well, so you're not really saying no, you're just saying it's too soon.
If you like.
Well, I guess I'll just have to put up with that for the time being.
I'll make you something really special. I'm sorry I can't stay, but the kitchen calls.
What are we celebrating? Ingrid's new job?
I'm not sure Javier is too pleased about that. But we do have some good news for you. We have the date for the marriage blessing. February the 14th.
That's our wedding anniversary!
I knew you'd be pleased.
That's very kind of you. Thank you, Javier.
Good evening, ladies. Table for two.
Marcus, Lisa and I need to see you. Here.
Yeah, I'll be right there. And Pilar? Nothing. I'll tell you when I see you.
You want me to get all this for tonight?
Please. I feel like pushing the boat out a bit tonight.
And is there any particular reason why you're feeling like this?
Well, I'm working. I can afford to. So I'm going to.
Yeah, that's another thing. Like you said, you're working.
So?
So, you're not going to be back till late, especially not with the Fernandes having their big day tomorrow.
Jerry, it stays as it is, okay?
Well, all I'm saying is, wouldn't it be better to rearrange it?
No, it wouldn't.
So, you're going to be all right living with your family and stuff, yeah?
I don't know. I'm beginning to think that might have been a mistake. But that doesn't mean I would come back to you. There are other places, other things to do.
Other men?
I care a lot about you. I can imagine being with another man.
Come back to me.
Hi.
I'm dressed up especially for the occasion.
Ooh, you look smashing.
Oh, good. Some of them are here.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Oh, Ingrid, hang on a minute. I just want to check something out.
But Jerry.
Oh, you're here already, are you? Sorry. Come on in. Back it.
You should not have come.
I know.
But I'm glad you have.
It's just that I forgot to give you your wedding present. It was John's, but I thought you'd like it. It's an Egyptian cat. For luck and fertility. Not that you need that. I shouldn't have come. I'll go.
Wait. Read this later. After the blessing.
Paco.
No. Not today, Freddy. Do as I say.
Thank you.
It's so nice to see you again. I missed you so much.
Even though I was always so difficult.
Yes. Even then. And what about you? Did you miss me just a little bit?
Yes, but that doesn't mean I won't spend the rest of my life with you.
Everyone is waiting. We have to do something.
Okay, okay. Is there only one way to come from the hotel?
Yes, I think so, yeah.
Maybe he went a different way, but they said he was in his room. Where else can we look, Pablo? Come on. No, no. Pablo, open the windows, please. Quick.
Pilar, what I'm going to say to you now, I've never said to anybody, okay? I love you. I love you with all my heart.
I'm sorry, I have to find my parents.
Now, you might remember, we had a chat about where this relationship was supposed to be going.
Yes.
Well, I actually had to go away and have a think about that. And it took a little bit longer than I expected. See, I want to get things straightened out between you and me.
Be serious.
I am being serious, Pilar. I've never been more serious in my life. I want you to marry me. I'm proposing.
Dear Freddy, now you're reading this letter, the blessing is over, and in the eyes of my family, I am properly married. Nothing can change the fact that I am Ingrid's husband. I know we agreed not to meet again, but I spent a long time thinking last night. I have to get married. You understand it. But our times together were very important to me. So, if you agree, I think we should still meet. Let me know what you think. Here, Paco.
What's going on?
I just kids mucking about.
Stanley, what is it?
Nothing.
You've been like this for 2 days now.
I'm fine.
One executive assistant reporting for duty.
One executive prat, more like. I run a business, not a beach party.
I don't understand.
What the hell have you got on?
I always dress like this.
Yeah, well, not when you work for me, you don't. I can't have my staff running around in Humpty Dumpty's cast-offs, can I?
But these are the only clothes I've got.
Well, we just have to do something about that then, won't we?
At last!
Hello.
Do you know, you can pick up really juicy bits of gossip down at that plaza. I have just discovered that my son is working for Marcus Tandy. Mind you, it's not major gossip. Apparently, everyone's known about it for a couple of weeks except me. Now, what on earth made you think you could keep someone like that for me?
Look, I was going to tell you. I was just waiting for the right time.
Oh, the right time. I see. Now, what would be the right time? The first time the police come knocking on the door.
Thank you.
Thank you. I think Javier would be pleased if he could see us now, don't you? Of course. It's just sad he's not here to share in it.
Excuse me.
Everything all right? Up to now?
Excellent, Freddie.
Good.
What is it? For God's sake, tell me.
I lied to you. I am not a doctor.
So what are you then, Stanley?
Thank you, Doctor. I'm sorry we bothered you.
No bother.
I'll see you out.
No need, really. I can find my way.
Something wrong?
This photograph.
Javier? You know Javier?
Yeah.
We haven't seen him around for a while. He used to come down the club quite a lot. With his friend, the Englishman.
Englishman? What Englishman?
Freddy. If you know Javier, you must know Freddy.
Yes, I think I do.
What did you do for a living, they'd say, and I told them I'd been a nurse. They'd say I was more like a doctor.
Because of your bedside manner.
Spring cleaning.
Just tell me then.
Tell you why I brought you all here?
Yes.
No, you tell me.
Tell you what?
You must have something you want to tell me.
I know I didn't act very well back in England.
All right, 9 minutes.
And I know you were right to walk out on me like that, and I didn't deserve anything else. But if I could just... explain.
Look, what is there to explain? You are what you always were, Terry. A waster. End of explanation.
Joy, I'm here now. Let's just spend a few days together. No strings. No complications. No pressure.
Time's up.
Joy. Joy?
Is this going to make you feel any better? Is that it?
I want to know about your relationship with my son.
There was no relationship. We were friends, that's all.
Ah.
So we were friends.
So now you were friends?
So what's wrong with being friends? Well, now what happens, eh? What happens? You bring me out here somewhere quiet so you can take it out on me because I was friends with your son.
I didn't know what I brought you up here.
I think I know.
I need the time to think, I suppose.
And
now I want you to tell me about my son!
You know about your son?
No, I don't know about my son. I don't think I ever did.
Then why don't you leave it like that? Because this is not going to achieve anything.
Oh, yes, it is.
What?
You had a friend, didn't you? Visited you every Saturday?
Today?
Everybody knows about him.
Problem of living in a small community.
Yeah, but nobody ever saw him, though.
Maybe he never existed.
You still see him? Why not?
Because I don't.
Because you can't! What did they call him?
Paco.
Paco was Javier, wasn't he? Javier was the person who secretly visited you, wasn't he?
Good God, what? I haven't seen him for nearly 30 years.
Who?
Alex Morris.
Alex Morris? Yeah, well, who is he?
He's a very old friend.
What kind of old friend? Ooh, that kind of old friend.
I'm not stupid, you know. Whatever was said out there today, I know the truth. But that is between you and me. And Rosario must never, never find out.
Roberto.
I don't care how you do it. Just do it.
Whatever you think, Javier had nothing but respect for you and Rosario. Your son loved you very much indeed.
Stanley, do you now wish at this ceremony today to be married to this woman, Rosemary?
I do.
Rosemary, do you now wish at this ceremony today to be married to this man, Stanley?
Sorry, Stanley. I'm so sorry.
Daddy bought you home for your birthday, did he?
Need any help?
What are you doing here?
Just happened to be passing.
Of all the clubs in all the world, you happen to be passing this one.
It's good to see you, Trish.
And you.
I've been waiting for you.
You took my breath away.
Then we're quits. You did just the same to me earlier.
Do you want to come in?
Mm-hmm.
Hello, Mitt. Best girl. Mummy's home. It's a good girl, Mum. It's your best girl. Now, this is Alex. He's a mate, so don't go for his ankles. Yourself.
I'm Terry.
Of course you are.
Are you having a bit of a breather?
Yes, I thought I'd have a little drink and a little chat.
Is it all right if I take the stage? We fancy a bit of a sing-song.
Oh, help yourself. You probably will with this track record.
Right, come on. 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 Come on.
Popular girl.
So what time's his flight?
Actually, he's staying a few days.
You do surprise me.
I surprised myself.
I see.
Tell me, how did you manage to get everything arranged in time for tomorrow?
Oh, that was no problem.
I only wish I could have been of some use to you.
Just get better in time. That's all that's important.
Listen, I'll be at that registry office if you have to wheel me there in an iron lung. Anyway, we finally did it.
Smile, everybody.
I got some business to sort out.
You didn't tell me.
What? I'm sorry, I forgot.
Doesn't matter.
You really are extraordinary. You use my flat as a doss house.
I don't.
You use my bar as some sort of pickup joint.
What do you mean?
You use my till as your own private bank.
I said I'll get the money back for
and
you.
And you call it teething problems. Well, I call it something else, Terry. I call it contempt.
What?
You must really despise me to treat me the way you do, or hate me, or both.
I love you.
If that's how you show your love, God help your enemies. Just take your cases and go.
You don't mean it. I don't want you to rush into something you're going to regret in the morning, Joy.
Terry, the only thing I regret is ever having set eyes on you. Now get out.
Rosario is still in a terrible state, of course. And poor Roberto, I'm sorry for him. It's had to be strong for both of them.
What about you? How do you feel, Ingrid?
Me? Oh, I hardly count. Javier was their son, that's all they think about.
Scotch. Any news on Joy?
She's still unconscious.
So she hasn't said who did it yet, then?
No, but I'm sure she will when she comes round.
If she comes round. Well, well. Isn't this cosy?
Can I have a look, then? Mm. Oh, my love forever, Terry.
Trish, he has been very good to me since my accident.
Mm. And what's his ulterior motive? That's what I'd like to know.
Look, who else have I got? I'm going home tomorrow. You're off God knows where.
I'm only going for 2 weeks. That's no reason to sell your soul to the devil, dear.
Whatever you say, Trish, he is not a devil. He has been very caring and very thoughtful.
All right, I won't say another word yet.
Excuse me, I'm looking for Marco Standi.
Oh, yeah, you and everyone else.
What?
He'll be back. Excuse me, girls. Let me guess, champagne, hmm? You seem a pretty girl to be one of Marcus's hangers-on.
I'm not a hanger-on.
Woo-hoo, wonderful. You've got spirit, I like that.
Will Marcus be back soon?
He won't want to keep you waiting, Miss...
Moreno.
Well, Miss Moreno. Pleased to meet you. Morris. Alex Morris. Sit down.
So you're a close friend of Marcus, yeah?
Very close.
Oh, really?
What do you think of him?
Why do you ask?
Because I don't know very much about Marcus and his past life.
Less said, the better. Don't you agree?
Are you really his friend?
Oh, I think so. Let's put it this way. When he got married, Marcus asked me to be his best man. I'd call that being his good friend, wouldn't you?
Why are the lights off?
I've got a brandy over there. Could you pass it to me, please? Thank you.
It's all coming back to her. Mm. She started walking towards the door, and she began to remember, didn't you, Joy?
Oh, it's close.
You mean you know who did it?
Okay, calm down. She's had a shock, right?
I felt terrified.
No, that's enough. It's okay. I mean, there's no point pushing it, is there?
Oh, it's all right for you. You can take care of yourself, can't you?
Yeah, I can also take care of Joy, which is what I'm trying to do.
I think I hate this place.
Yeah, I know. I shouldn't have left you here, should I?
Why don't you just take her home, yeah? Okay? Come on.
I'm supposed to be on your team, right?
Not yet.
Well, why not?
Not by a long chalk.
It's okay, he's gone.
I'm sorry to be so much trouble, but I had to catch you before you go to work and I didn't want to go into the house.
Whatever's the matter?
I haven't slept at all last night. I haven't said anything to anyone. And Marcus just thinks I'm being moody.
What about?
Ingrid, I found out something from this awful Englishman. Marcus is married. He's married.
God. My God.
So what about one for the road?
Who said anything about you having to hit the road? Ignore it.
Sure?
Positive.
I'm sorry, Trisha. I know it's late. I just wondered if you could put me up for the night.
What? You're not picky times, love.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. I just fancied a bit of company, that's all.
Company? What's up to Terry?
Trish, come back inside.
Look, forget it, Trish, okay?
Are you all right?
Yeah, yeah. I'm just being silly, that's all. I'll see you in the morning, okay?
Joy, what's wrong?
Nothing. Like I said, I'm just being silly.
Are you all right,
love? Yeah, I'm absolutely fine.
That loving next to your roller coaster.
What?
One minute they're up, the next minute they're down.
What are you talking about?
The odd couple over there.
Terry and Joy?
Yeah, nicest pie last night, daggers drawn this morning. I'll tell you, if she wants to stay here another night, I'm going to start charging her rent.
Joy! Joy! Gwen! Joy! This is ridiculous! I know you're in there.
What's going on?
Ashley, Trish, that's what I'm trying to find out myself.
Terry!
But I can't find out, can I? Because she won't answer the door to me. She's gone crazy, hasn't she?
Look, why don't you let us talk to her? Just me and Gwen, right? We'll try and calm her down. Right, and then we'll take it from there, OK?
Yeah. Yeah, OK. Just don't expect to get much sense out of her, that's all. All right?
Joy, Joy, it's me. Joy!
A beer, please.
I keep on seeing him all the time. I can't. Every time I close my eyes.
I don't understand who.
Just standing there, looking down at me.
What are you talking about, darling? What is it?
It was Terry.
What was Terry?
The man who attacked me. It was Terry.
What's all this?
What does it look like?
What's going on?
I have to go home. I tried to explain to you this morning, but you wouldn't listen to me.
Well, I was busy. What's the problem? Somebody sick? Come on, tell me. Oh, is this why you stormed out on me this morning? What's the problem? Look, Pilar, if you've got a problem, tell me, because I'll sort it out. I've told you before, anything you want, you just ask, you'll get it.
What about Alex?
What about him? You don't like him, do you? Come on, spit it out.
It's my father's birthday.
It's your dad's birthday? Is that all?
You still haven't told me what sort of fantasy she's supposed to be having.
I can tell you.
What?
And it's not a fantasy, is it, Terry?
What do you mean?
It's 100% fact, isn't it?
What are you talking about?
I always knew you were a bit unbalanced, but I never knew you were that evil.
Hey, now, hang on a minute.
Well, what do you call it? You attack your girlfriend, you leave her for dead.
Is that what she's been telling you?
She's remembered.
What?
What happened that night.
Now, look, just listen to me.
Every little detail.
I don't believe this. Joy, what the hell is going on? I don't believe this.
Really? Well, it took a lot for me to believe it myself. But it's true, isn't it?
Look, we've got to talk about this. You don't seriously believe it was me, do you?
I saw you, Terry.
Do you think you saw me?
I saw you.
Look, we've got to go inside and we've got to talk about this on our own, OK?
We stay with Joy.
This is ridiculous!
You're not very nice to know, are you, Terry?
Depends who you talk to, doesn't it?
Well, I've been asking around, but I haven't met anybody who's got a good word to say about you. Not one.
Well, popularity's always been an overrated virtue.
You think so?
Looks like you should know.
Don't get funny with me, son. Like I said, I haven't got much of a sense of humour.
Well, you should try and develop one then, shouldn't you? I'm off.
Now that, if you don't mind my saying so, was very silly.
Look, what's all this about?
I told you in the car, Joy Slater.
What's she to you?
She's a very good friend of a very dear friend of mine. And I don't like to see her hurt. Let him up. I'll be straight with you, Terry. There's one thing that gets under my skin. It's violence against women. Violence against men, on the other hand.
Are you threatening me?
I want you out of this country tomorrow at the latest.
Well, how am I going to get out when I haven't even got the money for an air ticket?
I'm sure a man of your undoubted resources can make suitable arrangements.
Or you could always lend me some cash.
Don't you remember? No sense of humour. I want you on a plane. How you get on it is your problem. In the meantime, Lenny will keep an eye on you to see that you don't come to any harm. You want to take care, Terry. There's a lot of nasty people out there. Hmm? Social visit. Haven't seen you for a few days. Thought I'd pop in, see how you are.
Oh, I'm never better, me. Walking on water. How'd you get up here, anyway?
You left the street door open. Not like you.
Yeah, well, I've had a lot on my mind just lately.
Anything I should know about?
It's personal.
Good. As long as it stays that way.
What?
As long as it doesn't interfere with our business.
It won't.
I'm delighted to hear it.
might be important.
Oh, I hate those things.
Yeah. Good. Marcus Townley. You know what to do? Right.
Now, as you can see here, a base camp has been set up here, which will be defended by the blue team. The aim of the red team will be to take the base camp by force after being dropped off here at the starting point. Okay?
Everything okay?
Yeah, there's nothing I enjoy more than a spot of babysitting.
Just a bit of PR. Used to be good at that.
Is that right?
Come to think of it, used to be good at a lot of things.
Marcus, you're late.
Yeah, well, I got a bit held up.
Never mind. Take your places quickly. You can get changed later. Your team leader will fill you in on what you've missed.
Who's that?
Drew.
How's it going? This is fun.
So how many do you reckon we've hit so far?
Well, that makes three for me. How many you got?
Well, I haven't actually had a direct hit yet.
Your mate's good. I saw him hit someone.
What mate?
The ones you brought earlier. Who are they, anyway?
Nosy. They're just business associates.
Well, is that why that bloke wanted to do the other day? To arrange it?
What bloke?
You know, that friend of Trisha's. He was here earlier. Wanted me to let him know if I saw you.
And you did?
Yeah. Why? Is that a problem?
I'm dead!
Oh, no.
Isabel!
I told you it was better in the tent. Is that allowed, thinking out on people?
Of course it's allowed.
You're dead, too.
You mean I'm dead as well?
Yes.
Oh, thanks God. My foot are killing me.
Must be nearly over now, nearly everybody's in.
Don't you believe I have left my team with a master plan. Just wait.
Come on then, Storming Norman. I'll buy you a cup of coffee.
Get on.
Been a while. Think we should go and look for them.
It's very quiet.
Come on. Come on. Come on, Faith.
Please. Somebody better call a doctor.
It's just a scratch.
You have to get this seen to.
Please don't make a
fuss. Let's get him back to the club.
Sebastian, what happened? Did you fall over?
Yeah. That's right. I fell over.
Ingrid, this is Sergio.
Pleased to meet you.
Very nice meeting you. Please sit down.
He's my husband.
Your what?
My husband.
Pilar, ever since she was little, she's had to shock people.
Well, congratulations. I don't know what to say.
I say I have lots to tell you.
Come on, Ed.
What?
But you promised the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
I said over lunch.
Yeah, well, we're not going to get any lunch unless you talk to me.
All right, what is it you want to know?
I want to know how you know Marcus.
He works for me. Well, he's more of a junior partner, really.
He works for you?
Well, don't look so surprised. You know, I've got various business interests out here, and Marcus handles them for me.
And what about his businesses?
What do you mean?
Well, Mark Anthony's, the clothes shop, the boat.
They're mine, too.
And the video shop.
That's right.
So you arranged it, did you, my job?
Of course not.
come on, no more lies, Alex.
No one was more surprised than me to find out you were working here.
And why don't I believe her, eh?
It's the truth.
Boys, boys, boys. Okay. Everything goes smoothly?
Yeah, no problem, mate. There you go.
Thanks, sir. Thank you very much. Cool then, anyway. Oh, Chris. Here, have a drink. Okay. All right, cheers.
Some business in Malaga.
I managed to finish early.
Great. Well, she's just coming up to her last number now. Finish that and we'll go round to the dressing room. I tell you, she could do with some friendly faces.
Yeah, I was talking to the manager, I gather that.
Yeah. To be honest with you, I don't know why they booked her for this place. If they had Carrera singing, maybe this lot will shut up and listen for a few minutes.
That bad, eh?
Yeah.
Look, do me a favour. You haven't seen me.
Oh, Alex, please don't go.
I'm not supposed to be here anyway.
Listen, it's really going to cheer up to see you.
I'll see you tomorrow.
She's going to be suicidal.
Trust me. I know what I'm doing. Cheers.
You got everything?
Yeah, looks like it. You know, I really am grateful for all this.
Too right you're grateful. And I tell you what, if you jump bail and my 30K goes west, you'll wish you stayed in the pokey, mate.
No, I'll show you, don't worry. You know, I didn't think you'd do this for me. I thought you just sacked me.
Yeah, well, don't think the idea hasn't occurred to me. Is that it? Okay, let's get out of this place. Gives me the jizz. You know, I've been keeping an eye on you just lately. You and I have been behaving like a prat.
What do you mean, keeping an eye on me?
Oh, wake up, Blair. How do you think I knew you were in this place when you rang?
Some perverse kick out of threatening my kid, or are you just desperate to get this job done? You know, if you were a real man, you would take the parcel to Marbella yourself. Everybody keeps telling me there's no risk in this, but no one wants to do it. Do you like to tell me why?
Drew, please, keep that bloody Scotch accent of yours down. I've got a headache.
Scots. The word is Scots.
Fine. Welcome to the Costa del Crime. Want a drink?
I don't want anything off of you. What's in this?
Please.
All right. I'll do this thing for you, this one thing, but you remember, after it, we are quits. The debt is settled. Finito, do you understand me?
Fine, Drew, what are you
doing? No, but I just want to get it clear from the start that if I do this, I owe you nothing, right?
Shut up!
So how'd it go?
You've got a nerve.
Joy told you.
Yeah, and what exactly were you doing there?
Well, I just wanted...
To pay them off for setting me up, yeah?
Hold on. What are you on about?
You know exactly what I'm on about. You set that gig up for me to fail.
You're crazy. Why would I do that?
I don't know.
Why did you do it, then?
What?
Go away like that. Get married.
Marcus, I've already told you. I didn't come here to talk about this. And I didn't come here to be cross-examined, Ada.
Okay.
We are talking for all time's sakes,
yeah,
all right?
Message received.
So, how is business?
I'd still like to know.
Are the stables all right?
I've been turning it over again and again in my head.
Sultan,
but I think I've got a right to know, Pilar.
Oh, you are a fine one to talk about rights, and you, Marcus.
What?
My right to know never concerned you, did it?
Your right to know what?
This is useless.
Your right to know what, Pilar?
About your marriage, Marcus. I know you lied to me, and I know you are married.
Pilar? Wait. You think I'm married?
I know you are married.
And how do you know this?
Because your friend told me.
What friend?
That one at the hotel.
Alex?
Yes, your best man. And that's why I left you, Marcus. Because our whole life was a lie.
No, Pilar. Our whole life wasn't a lie. What Alex told you was. I'm telling you the truth, Pilar. You gotta believe me.
You made £1,000.
How much?
I made £1,000.
You made £1,000 in one day.
Well, that's what I said, didn't I? Is anything wrong in that?
No. That was fantastic. Just that I've been so worried. You're absolutely sure that you made £1,000 in one day?
No. Yes.
You know, this is very difficult for me, Alex. Because it's you who screwed things up for me in the first place.
Come again.
You told Pilar I was married.
Yeah, I remember. I said I was best man at your wedding. So what? It was a joke.
A joke? You drive me halfway out of my mind, and that's a joke.
I've lost you, Marcus. What happened?
What happened? What happened is that she went off and married some other geezer. That's what happened.
I thought she was just a bit of fluff, making a nuisance of herself.
You know the score, Alex. You should have checked.
Yeah, but you can't blame me for what she did.
You caused me a lot of grief.
So what's the problem now? You still serious about her?
You serious about Trish?
Yes, I am.
All right, you know how I feel about Pilar, then.
Look, I tell you what. You've helped me with Trish. Perhaps I can return the favour. If your girl's married the wrong man, maybe there's something I can do about it. Hmm? I owe you a favor.
You owe me a lot more than that.
We should go out tonight and celebrate.
Yes, good idea.
It was stupid, I know, but I did have real doubts about moving to Los Barcos at first. Because of all that happened to you here. But now it seems like the best thing that could have happened to us.
Yes, I'm glad.
It can be a real first start. I don't even worry about Marcus anymore. I saw him last night going to his boat with his new girlfriend.
What?
Yeah, she's very, very young, though, but good luck to him. I think he's making a first start, too. We should be happy for him. Pilar, are you right?
Yes, of course.
Good.
It's come to a point when we have to put our cards on the table.
Oh, yeah.
There are things I need to know, and I want you to be totally honest. Agreed?
Agreed.
My gigs, not just the one in Marbella. You arranged them, didn't you?
Yeah.
And the video shop? You said it was just coincidence. But you did ask Marcus to set it up, didn't you?
Yes, but to...
I'm trying to get somewhere.
Trish, you've got to understand something. I did all these things out of love.
Thank you.
For what?
Now, I can say to you, Alex, get lost. I want you out of my life forever.
Trish. Trish. Hold on. I've made a lot of mistakes. And the biggest one was letting you go in the first place. I regret that more than anything. And if I could give up all this, all what I've got today, and turn the clocks back and stay with you, I'd do it. If I have interfered in your life, it's because I don't want to let you go again. You're the most important part of my life.
What are you trying to tell me?
I'm asking you to marry me. What do you say?
Yes?
I'll report a man you're looking for. Never mind my name. Just get a pencil and write down his.
I'll get a coin then, shall I?
Why not?
None of this best of three, though. You just take it as it comes, right? Heads, you marry him. Tails, you don't. Go on.
Toss a coin. I mean it. Go on, then. What is it, heads or tails?
It's heads, Trish. Heads you go.
Robert and Rosario, they want to see you.
No, I don't want to see them, Pilar. Tell them to leave me alone.
Come on, Rosario. We wait a while.
I have to see Ingrid. She needs me now.
We shouldn't bother her now. Dr. Ferreira's a friend of mine. He'll keep us informed. Come on.
What's going on?
Get in, we got problems.
What's happening? Nah. We heard a baby crying.
Ingrid has had a boy. To kill us, baby boy.
How is she? How is she?
Oh, she's fine.
And the baby. Is the baby okay?
Yeah, he's beautiful.
So who grassed?
Take your pick. I've had my ear to the ground on this one. I should think the old village knows by now. Anyway, if I was you, I'd stop worrying about how it went wrong and start worrying about how to put it right.
Ingrid rang. She said we can go and see the baby now.
Oh, good. About time. Come on.
You heard. Ingrid had a little boy.
Yes, congratulations.
We were so worried about him. He had to go in a special incubator. And Ingrid was so distressed, she wouldn't let us see him.
Rosario, come on.
If you have the chance, Freddy, why don't you go and see her? She'd
yes,
love that.
Congratulations.
It's about time we go, Rosario.
Yeah.
I'd have brought these earlier, only I got a bit tied up.
I'll give them to Ingrid. Thank you.
Funny, isn't it?
What?
This.
What do you mean?
I've imagined this scene a lot of times. Me bringing you flowers in hospital. And it was you having a baby. Our baby.
Marcus.
Funny. Odd though, isn't it? I'm going to sail away and rot in the Caribbean and you're still going to be here as free as a lark. But between you and me, Marcus, I'd be careful if I was you. It always happens when you're least expecting it. See ya.
Alex. Thank you. Yeah.
Let's go.
Hold it. You've left it late.
Here seems to think that the only interest a woman could possibly have is her baby. Oh, now you're making me feel bad too, Pilar.
Why? Go home if you want to. That doesn't mean you're a bad mother. No one will think that.
I just don't feel much for him yet, Pilar. I mean, I feel as if it's got nothing to do with me.
Come on. Let's go home. This place is enough to drive anyone crazy. Come on, let's go and do it.
Yeah. What
did we come out here for? I mean, we're not bosom buddies. Why me?
Well, you like fishing. I like fishing. I thought we'd go fishing.
Yeah, and the rest.
Are you suggesting that I've got some sort of ulterior motive?
Look,
Drew, you've enjoyed the little luxuries I've put your way, the money I've stuffed your way. Don't deny it.
Oh, I don't deny it. I enjoy the good life, and the money has come in handy.
So maybe we could do some more business together.
And have declared the same by giving and receiving of a ring, by joining of hands, I pronounce that they be man and wife together, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Hey, give us a hand here, eh?
Hey? Oh.
Who's he? Forget it, I've lost it.
It's for the drink.
Nah, not for me. I haven't touched one for months. In fact, I think I've gone off it.
Sure I could.
Pilar, is it?
Do you know why she got married?
Well, it's someone she knew when she was growing up.
Yeah, something like that.
Maybe she hasn't forgotten him.
She didn't mention him all the time I was living with her.
Well, maybe you were just a holiday romance. You know, she packed up her souvenirs, moved back to the real world. Women are devious like that.
She's not devious.
Well, it looks like it to me. I mean, she leaves you and 5 minutes later, bang, she's got a ring on her finger.
It's not the way it was.
Oh.
Someone told her that I was married.
What?
For a joke. Someone told her that they'd been my best man. She believed them.
So she married this guy out of spite?
It's not spite.
She married him out of love?
She loves me.
Well, that's your problem, mate.
Good kidding.
Morning, Mrs. Morris.
Morning. Should have done this years ago, shouldn't we?
Years ago, I didn't have one of these to do it on. Still, we've got plenty of time to make up for every lost minute.
I'm still trying to catch up with myself. I feel stunned. It's you and me, a crew I hardly know from Adam, and all this sea.
Feels like freedom to me. Feels just perfect.
Yeah, it is.
Hey. Hey. What happened?
You fell. The horse is a bit lame and I didn't want you to make it any worse.
Hey. It's not been your day, is it?
It's nothing. I feel happy. It was good to ride again.
Good. Nothing to take out my horses, though, is it? Come on, climb up.
You have to help me. My leg hurts.
Hey, how's this? You okay?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. You need a bath. Ha, come on. Go.
Alex, I really wish you would tell me where we're going. Well, I've got a few commitments back home, you know, things I didn't manage to sort out before we left.
You're determined to spoil my surprise, aren't you?
No, I'm not, darling. But I know what you like. You do like to be a bit sort of over the top. So if you've planned, say, a month's cruise, for instance, well, I'd just assume we turn back now.
Turn back?
Marcus offered me a job.
What?
For a few weeks, running the stables for him. The whole place. What do you think?
Did you say yes to him?
I say we'd talk about it.
And we have, and now you can tell him no.
Sergio!
I say no, no, finish it up, no more! If you can't say no to that animal, I'll go home without you!
I want to talk about it when you are not so angry with me.
It's like a disease. You know, sometimes I don't know whether to kill him, kill you, or kill myself. Maybe one day I will do all three.
Brandy?
Yes, brandy and an answer, please, Alex.
Brandy.
I also have a life too, you know.
Listen, Trish, very carefully. I can't go back to Spain for the moment. To be quite honest, I don't think I'll ever be able to go back to Spain.
Pilar, can you just hold this while I tie it round?
Mm-hmm. Marcos,
you must know how I feel about you.
It's not good.
Why?
Do you know why?
You don't love Sergio, and you never did.
No, we mustn't do this.
I dream about this moment. I dream about this moment all the time. Oh, is this what you want? You want to be stuck in a marriage that means nothing to you?
But, Sergio...
Leave Sergio, Pilar. Leave Sergio and come with me.
What's that for?
I'm going to short.
Yeah, but of course you are. But we're both going to short, but you don't need that.
Well, I'm staying, Alex, all right?
But what's going on? What's this all about, Trish?
You know what it's all about, Alex. It's no good. You present me with this bombshell. I want you to book me into a hotel on my own.
Can't it find, Drew?
Sorry about that. I get held up at the christening and couldn't get away. It was difficult.
I don't like to keep people waiting, especially when they might have been waiting for years already.
So who are these people? People we're selling the passports to?
You've been drinking?
No.
Good. Because you're going to need your wits about you tonight. I don't want to take anyone out who isn't 100%.
Look, I'm fine. Honest.
Good.
It's no use. I've made my mind up. I'm going back to Spain. It just wouldn't work. Can't you see?
You might want to. You do as you talk.
Let go! I can't stand it!
So why did you marry me, eh?
I can't.
There must be a reason. So what was it?
No.
Yes! I want the truth!
All right. I married you because I couldn't marry Marcos. Because someone told me he was married and I believed them.
How cool you.
Do you ask for the truth?
So you married me when you wanted him?
Yes!
Why?
Because I wasn't thinking at the moment and...
And what?
And I want to make him feel jealous. I felt so angry with him.
So you marry me just to make another man jealous?
No. But he's unmarried after all. It was a mistake.
That's why you want to go back to Los Barcos?
You had a job here, remember? I didn't want to come back. You did.
I knew it. I knew we should have never come here. I knew that.
It doesn't matter where I am, Sergio, here or at home. I can't forget Marcos. And I'm sorry, but things can work between us. I will always love Marcos. I want a divorce.
Never!
That's what I want!
Never! Never and never!
Yes! Drew?
You know my friend that works at the police station?
The typist
friend? Yeah, she gave me a little snippet of information.
Yeah.
About how the police got to Felipe Calago.
Yeah?
She reckons it was an English bloke that tipped them off. And I think we both know what English bloke it is. Runs a health club. Drives a flash motor. Had a little accident at some war games recently.
Yeah, all right, Eddie. You no need to spell it out for me.
Enough lies from you and Blair to last me a lifetime. You're both the same. Always on the fiddle. Always slightly on the wrong side of the law. Always just a little bit dodgy. Maybe it's hereditary.
Oh, fuck. Well, how do you explain Nessa in that case, eh? She's as straight as a die.
Oh, that's easy.
Oh, really, is it?
Yes.
Yeah, would you like to explain it then?
Nessa isn't yours, Drew.
Eddie, I've got something to tell you.
Uh-huh.
I'm leaving Spain. I'm going home. I am. I'm going to go back and live in England for good.
Time for more celebration, I think.
Indeed, good thing I've run away.
Well, you have, haven't you?
I can't.
Pilar, don't spoil this. Don't
Let's spoil this moment. After all, it's my birthday, remember?
I remember.
You and me, you know. We're meant for each other. So, I wasn't imagining things. It was you I saw earlier on.
Well, you don't look too pleased about it, Marcus. And I haven't heard so much as a welcome home yet.
Welcome home?
You still don't sound ecstatic.
Just a bit surprised, that's all.
And why is that?
Well, with Felipe in prison just about to sing a song, I'd have thought.
So you haven't heard them?
What?
Felipe's had an accident.
I see.
In his cell. A sort of accident that means he's no longer a threat.
Just a stroke of luck, wasn't it?
Not for Felipe.
So what made you change your mind then about coming to see me off?
You just said it.
Did I?
Come to see you off. I sat in the apartment and I thought about John and Javier. And I thought, well, it's not often you get a chance to say goodbye. Seemed a bit stupid to miss out on this one as well.
Well, I'm glad you didn't.
So am I.
And I will write.
You're going to miss that plane if you're not careful.
No, I haven't got hours yet.
You never leave enough time to check in. You know that. It takes at least an hour at this time of the year.
Not when you only got hand luggage, you
don't. Why is it that you always have to argue with me?
I'm not arguing with you.
Yes, you do. It sounds like it to me. Nag, 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 as bad as a blooming wife.
Drew? Oh, Drew. I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
I shouldn't... Not after all this time, I just shouldn't...
Shouldn't have what? Told me the truth? I take it was the truth. You just didn't say that to hurt me.
Yes, it was the truth.
Who then?
That teacher at my school, the one I told you about when you were in hospital. So what does all this mean then? That you're leaving?
Yeah, that's the idea.
Well, I could hardly blame you, could I? Why are you still here?
Why did you stay with me all these years?
Because I loved you.
Yeah, well, that's why I'm still here. Because I love you.
You remember what I said?
Please, sir.
I will never give you a divorce. I won't allow it. I'd rather kill you than have that man have you.
It's too late now. I was with him last night and I'm going back to him tonight.
What's so important? Car needs servicing.
That's important?
Yeah, take it to the dealers in Marbella.
Really?
Yeah, don't hang about either.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to upset you.
But it's a bit too late, isn't it?
We're leaving Spain just like that?
Yes.
And we're going back to England?
Yes.
All of us?
Yes.
And we're not going back there for a holiday, we're actually going to go back...
We are selling up, Nessa. We're going home for good just as soon as we can. We're going to put the villa in the hands of a solicitor and we'll put the furniture into store for a while.
Well, then you better start telling me why, haven't you?
very slippery. Then again, if we can't get Marcus...
Pilar! Wait,
Hey, that is enough. You wake up the baby. We told you Pilar isn't here.
So where is she then?
Are you sure about that? Okay, listen carefully. This is exactly what I want you to do.
I thought you'd turn up sooner or later.
I've had better welcomes. Yep, I've read about it.
And I suppose you had nothing to do with it.
As it happens, no, I didn't. The only reason I'm here is because before you left, I asked you if you thought we had a chance if we'd stayed in Spain. You never gave me that answer. I'm here for that answer now. I'm staying at the usual place. If you want me.
I know you don't understand why we have to go back, but believe me, it's for the best.
For who exactly?
We can't stay here. There's nothing here for us.
Nothing for you, you mean?
I'm doing this for all of us, for the family.
Oh, do me a favour, Dad. You've never done anything for this family, ever. The only reason you do anything is for yourself.
Nessa!
Well, it's true.
It isn't true.
It is true. Give me one instance when he's done anything for anybody but himself.
I thought I'd never see you again.
Did anyone see you?
No, I did everything you said.
Why do you always blame him?
Maybe because it's always his fault.
Look, I know he's not perfect, but then nobody is. Not even you. But I am sick of you always seeing the bad in him.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. Why won't you ever remember the times when he sat up all night with you? Times when he walked for miles, pushing your wheelchair, just trying to find something to make you smile.
Oh, and I meant to be grateful, Emma.
Yes. Oh, if you only knew.
What? No, come on, tell me.
Forget it.
What should I know now that I've got to be eternally grateful for this time?
I don't want to talk about it.
Well, I do. Tell me.
Nothing!
Come on, tell me, I want to know.
All right, you really want to know,
yes,
do you?
All right, then.
I'll tell you. Yes, Drew is not your father.
Has to be goodbye, Pilar. There's people out there and they're trying to kill me.
I don't care. I want to be with you.
Well, you come. You're going to slow me down.
I won't.
Yes, you will. Now, look. Just go back to your husband.
But I don't want him. I want you. Why are you treating me like this?
I don't love you, Pilar. The truth is, I don't think I ever did, not really.
It's not true. You're just saying that because you don't want me to come with you.
Listen to me.
No. The things you say to me, you can't tell me they were lies.
Oh, come on, Pilar. How could I resist it? I knew you'd never stay with me unless you thought I loved you. And remember, I've always been a great liar.
What about the other night?
I just wanted to prove I could have you again. I did, didn't I?
Please, why are you doing this?
Don't make this any harder than it already is.
Go away.
Go without him.
So what we're gonna do? Wait here all night?
Well, you go and I'll stay.
No, you go, I'll stay.
Where have you been?
We've got help up. Come on, we better
come
go.
On.
You pig.
Oh, look. It's Hubby.
You're still going to be the same person wherever we go. Don't you think it would be better to face up to things instead of running away all the time?
I don't know if I've got the strength, love.
I love you, Dad. I'll always love you. I've been sitting here thinking that I love that man. I don't care if he's not my real dad. He'll always be that to me.
So you don't want to find your real dad, then?
I'm looking at my real dad. You know who else would put up with me going on at them the way I do to you? Oh, come on, Dad. Let's go back. Let's show them we're not beaten, that we're only just starting.
What are we going to tell your mother?
What would you say if I said I was sorry for everything and that we should stay here and try and get it right? Come on, what would you say? Oh, I love you. I'll go and tell Blair.
What did you say to him?
Nothing that he didn't already know.
Alex, this is hopeless. It's like looking for a needle in a haystack.
Look, I don't care how long it takes. Just get out there and find him. And the next time you call, I want to hear that it's been sorted. Okay?
Drew! You're back!
Yes!
Fantastic!
You're back?
Oh, yes.
Fraser!
What are you doing back?
We're not going after all.
What?
My dad's all set.
Where's Marcus?
Marcus?
Yes, where is he?
I don't know.
I think you do.
Why should I know where Marcus is? He's a big boy now. He can go where he likes. He's got nothing to do with me.
That's not true. It's got everything to do with you.
Alex, it's sorted.
Tell me, do you recognize this? We're not sure. He was involved in some kind of car accident. I'm afraid his car caught fire. I'm very sorry, Miss Moreno.
Oh, Trish. Trish.
Have you heard about Marcus?
Marcus?
What about Marcus? He's dead.
Excuse me.
Pilar.
It's a note for Pilar.
Pilar, it's a note for you.
Will you read it?
It's from Sergio. He says, can you meet me at the marina? He needs to talk to you. Urgently.
gets worse and worse. First Felipe dead, now Marcus. Oh, it's all very convenient, isn't it?
Not for them.
No, for you, though.
They weren't a problem to me. Neither of them.
I realise that.
I always get what I want.
This time you don't.
Oh, yes. Definitely this time. Maybe not today, nor tomorrow. But soon. Real soon.
Right on time.
Things have turned out perfectly.
What?
Everything. You and me. Cheers.
Cheers. But what about the bracelet? What was it doing in the car?
I must have dropped it.
And there was a boy in there. Who was it?
The same unfortunate so-and-so that stole my car, I guess. I'd know, Pilar. You can't trust anyone these days, can you?
You wanted freedom, I wanted you. That glitters is never white.